attractive people. I want to welcome you to my hometown of Copewood Falls. I'm Bridget, your sassy redheaded best friend, and I will help you fall in love with our quaint community. Every small town has a couple of quirky rules that we have to follow. Number one, please silence your cell phones. Nothing ruins a good romantic moment like a cell phone. Number two, please do not take any videos or use flash photography tonight. I know, our town is adorable, but we have to follow the rules so that we don't get sued. And number three, the most important rule of all, be present. We want you to enjoy yourselves, so laugh, cry, gasp, and awe to your heart's content. That's it. Now, sit back, relax, and get ready to fall in love as Warren Theater presents the Holiday Channel Christmas movie Wonderthon.
No, for the whole place. I've got a vision for fixing this place up. Well, first bulldozing it to dust and then rebuilding. Two words for you. Artisanal smoothies. Have kale over here, and quinoa smoothies over here, and a primitive grain station over here. Everyone will be so darn regular. No. First the wrecking ball, and then the bulldozers. Oh, this place will look fantastic as a pile of rubble in a landfill. People from the big city need their juices, and they will trample anyone that tries to stop them.
The Evergreen is a staple of Hopewood Falls, Vermont. My grandfather built all of this by hand.
Your grandfather was terrible at building inns.
You can't do this all yourself.
Oh, I think you will, Mrs. Gooden.
It's Miss Gooden, actually. I'm not married, even though I'm really, really attractive. See, I've had a hard time finding love since my parents died, and this inn has been the only thing keeping me going.
Well, you've got 24 hours to sell it to me before I take it using eminent domain.
I'll fight this.
Here's my card, Holly, and happy holidays.
Monster! Guess there's no need to hang this mistletoe then. There's nobody to kiss. It's so tough to be alone on Christmas when you're really, really attractive.
It's so snowy out there.
You're over there talking to
Since you're wrong about everything, why not also be wrong about this?
Actually, matter.
Yes! What are you doing here?
I booked a writer's retreat. You see, I'm working on a new romance novel. Overcome by Joy. It's going to be amazing. If I could just figure out the heroine. You see, sometimes I have trouble with heroines. I just have to figure out the heroine. Maybe that's why I'm alone. On Christmas.
Christmas is just a day, Paul. It's about time you recognize that. Jeez. Sorry? Oh no, I didn't mean to upset you.
Her mother died on Christmas. She blames it for all of her many, many, many life problems. Only she would let me in so I could fix her entire life.
Yes,
No, thank you.
Hey, Holly, I'm just finished up back there. Well, hello, boys. Don't mind me. I'm Bridget. This is your sassy redhead best friend. Here to talk about you behind your backs.
Well, I guess I'd better get going then. Cheers. See y'all later.
Mams, I've got some rain.
So?
What? Mm-hmm. Don't you start. I don't have time for love in my life right now. Gotta save me in. Stop it.
Still planning on burning this place down for insurance money?
I don't know. I think my grandfather would probably disapprove.
I think your grandfather would understand. The girl's gotta eat. Speaking of which, maybe you can make dinner for one of those guys.
Which one?
Does it matter? The first one, I guess. They're basically interchangeable. Okay.
us, Mary. They don't have the reservation. I don't care if your hamster is sick. You make the reservation, dang it. I don't pay you to take care of rodents.
Hello? Yes, there is a room available. All right, thanks.
I believe I have a reservation.
What brings you to town? What do you mean by that?
Just a question.
Well, it's not to find love, that's for sure.
Clearly.
I don't have time for a boyfriend, even though I'm very, very attractive. Life in the big city is tough, especially with my job.
What did you do?
Lawyer, real estate, business president. It's very important. And if you'll excuse me, I have some important meetings to do on my cell phone, which shows exactly how important I am right now. Yeah, this is Mary. Oh, stop crying, Steve!
What?
No, I wasn't gonna say it.
I'm saying it. A girl like that, with no love in her heart.
Really hope she runs into one of the really, really attractive men that live here in Hopewood Falls.
We're never gonna make it in this rate. Can we speed this up, please?
Woo, is it snowing out there? You're probably wondering what I'm doing here, so...
Can you believe there are no flights after that?
Oh, I believe so.
Said it before and I'll say it again. I'm not playing Santa Claus this year.
Yes, yes, I'm famous. I know. No autographs.
All right, just say your name and sex. All right, let's go.
My name's Noelle. I make personalized Christmas ornaments and I'm big into Christmas. Super alone and desperate for love.
Oh, I'm Chris. I'm supposed to play Santa in town parade this year, but... my dad had that job, and he died on Christmas! Super alone and sad.
My name is Finn.
Yeah! I am from small country of Roxenberg that no one has ever heard of.
I am, peasant, here on vacation of a lifetime.
Also, very alone and sad.
I mean, obviously, y'all know me. Nope.
Are you an exotic dancer?
No! I'm here to St. John! Hello. I'm filming a movie nearby.
Oh!
You're a camera person, then?
Yes! Fine, if that's what you want to believe. And I'm alone on Christmas, even though I'm really, really attractive. And really sad. Me too.
Y'all.
What are the odds?
No. Okay, everyone to the rooms.
Can I tell them my secret? That I'm really Prince of Roxenberg, here looking for love. I love dogs.
be weird otherwise. But I haven't been able to smile at a woman since Grace passed away.
Aww. Man, this sure is a change from my last job. None of the buildings are even burned down. Maybe this Christmas isn't so bad after all.
Come on, guys. Let's go home. Alone, as always.
Well... Hello? Hello? Are you okay? Oh no, he's in a coma. I'm seriously good at diagnosing comas on the fly. It's too bad. You seem like a really nice guy, but kind of hard to find. Especially ones that are conscious. There's these two dogs here. See? Prancer. And Vixen. Christmas fan, huh? Well, I guess these are my dogs now. Come on, guys.
If you're not enchanted with it, I'll sell. But if you are enchanted with it,
You gotta go back to that big CD of yours and tell them to leave us the heck alone!
You know, that sounds like a really reasonable way to settle real estate deals.
Chris, you have to listen to me!
It's too late for me, Noel. That part of my life is behind me.
Your father was the best Santa Claus you've ever had.
Don't you speak about my father. He gave his life to Santa. What did he ever get out of it?
$10 an hour, I think.
That's not enough. Playing Santa took everything out of him. I think it's what killed him.
I'm pretty sure it's not.
What do you know anyway? Sitting in your bespoke Christmas ornament shop, making bespoke Christmas ornaments all your life because that's totally a realistic way of making a living? You don't know anything.
Your father loved being Santa Claus!
He loved it too much!
I don't think that's possible!
No, it's cool. Stay still. Maybe they won't notice us.
He was Santa. His belly was like a wall full of jelly crates.
Well, mine isn't. I do crunches.
You can stop doing crunches and let yourself go.
Don't tempt me.
The pieces were like roses.
I can't be like that. I use skincare products.
The children need you. You know this. You know the Christmas parade is the single most important thing that happens here. If there's no Santa Claus, we'll probably end riots. Like last time.
I can't do it so well. I can't. Think of my emotions. My emotions are strong.
You're talking about what else going on in your life.
I have a lovely job as a lawyer real estate business person. I can't just drop everything and be Santa Claus.
The Christmas I grew up with.
That Chris is dead! They're tearing me apart! Leave me alone!
Chris, I am not giving up on you!
Fingers on?
Yeah.
This could be the perfect location for one of our scenes!
Imagine it.
Secret agents burst out from behind the Christmas trees and... tree. And then I kill them all right there.
That sounds beautiful.
You know, it's a lot of pressure being a role model for like millions of girls. Most of them can't even kill 30 to 40 ninjas.
Most of them wouldn't even try.
Exactly! Have these students been?
He's still parking the truck.
Oh, and please don't tell him about me being a super huge movie star. I just don't want him to treat me differently. You know, it's difficult being famous. Especially when people don't. No, you're famous. Right. You know what's the worst part about being famous? And wealthy. And really good looking. And talented. And funny. And really good looking. What? It's lonely. I can't find Mr. Right. I'm more worried he'll be interested in being Hollywood royalty. And not the real me.
What is the real you?
I wish I knew.
Jeez, no one can talk to that.
Thanks for giving me a ride out here, Sven, to scout locations, since I'm a lowly location scout. Wink.
And I'm a lowly, pleasant truck driver person. A wink. Sorry about small truck trash, or the offshore truck hasn't shown.
That's not really how that works.
Who is that?
Well, it's probably your rental car agreement.
Okay.
I like your truck, Sven. I like it a lot.
I like your riding.
I enjoy riding, especially in the back seat. Well, let's go look and talk for my location. I'm sure there are some adorable places we can stage. Shootouts!
Can I tell her my secret? That I'm really convinced of Roxenberg and I have
all
a
lot of money? We got a lot to get through.
Wow! No one can see us.
It's almost like we're not the most important characters in the story.
But you
figures. Time to get cracking. You can do this. You can write that scene. Monica woke up to find people. Ugh, come on, Brain.
Hey there.
Wait, weren't you just like...
I'm the sauce best friend. I'm not bound by laws of space or time.
No, I don't want hot cocoa. I want an idea.
Why don't you write a true crime?
I'm a romance writer, though, you know? Girl meets boy. Girl loses boy in freshy accident. Girl gets boy back after he's stitched back together after experimental surgery. Wild passion ensues, but the surgery doesn't hold, so the boy dies. I can't even get started, though.
What did you got?
The sun came up. That's it. That's hardly a sentence, and it's certainly not romantic.
What are you writing Christmas romances? Everybody loves Christmas romances.
You think?
We can make a movie change.
Like 38 movies worth per year.
Okay. Yeah, I can do this. Let's say she's a reindeer handler.
I love this.
And he is one of Santa's elves. But like a sexy one. Like the Lord of the Rings Santa's elf. Yeah. And she has been around the reindeer a lot lately. So she's extremely potent. The smell is intoxicating.
Oh, that's a little weird.
And then family is like totally racist against the elves, right? And the elves are all about blood purity, like in Harry Potter. Yeah. And then, no, listen here. And then there's this battle, right? And the reindeer join in. But the elves are too strong, so they kill all the reindeer and they eat venison for dinner. And then Santa is like,
you are all banished!
And then they're sent down to the icy wasteland until they all starve to death! Oh my god. That's horrible. Life is really hard.
Why don't you just check Twitter all day? Don't most writers just check Twitter all day?
Oh, yes. Absolutely, Paul. Oh, this is good.
Don't look at him.
I feel so good about myself. I'm pretty sure I'm a genius.
So what if the heroine was a baker? And then possibly...
Oh, this is a good part. Oh, yeah!
Do you mind?
I'm sorry, what?
Some of us are blocked over here.
That's just your brain?
Telling you to quit. He's not worth it, Joy. As your sassy best friend, I'm telling you, there are other fish in the sea.
Oh, this is the hot part. It is getting hot over here.
That's it. I am here on a retreat, and I cannot retreat when you are always advancing.
Maybe you should retreat somewhere else.
Look, I get it. You're a fancy pants writer from the big city with all your ideas and your book sales and the adoring fans throwing themselves at you, but some of us are stuck and need help.
You're wrong.
Oh, really?
I don't have any adoring fans throwing themselves at me. In fact, I'm alone on Christmas. I guess that's just the problem with writing romance for a living. Real life just doesn't measure up. I'm sorry I interrupted your writing session. I'll just go be alone in my room for a while. Spend some more time in my make-believe world. Since that's so much better than the world I'm living
in. Oh, wait. No. I'm sorry. I was being really rude.
Yes, you were being rude. I agree with you.
This retreat just isn't working out how I wanted it to.
Maybe we just need a change of scene.
I have an idea! Maybe you two could go down to Hopewood Falls. I'm sure there's some romantic Christmas activities that can get you out of your slump.
With him?
With her?
No, not a chance. I'd rather pair up with the other very attractive single men around here.
Maybe you and I could do some of those romantic Christmas-themed activities.
I'm a sassy best friend. I'm very self-indulgent.
You can get sassy with me.
All right, stop. You're both romance writers. You're going to be together. Quit fighting it.
But like, out of all the guys.
I know that. I have actual customers this weekend. This time, I think most of them are paying in real money.
So, hello? Hello?
They hung up on me. The bank hung up on me.
But you've got actual customers now.
But you're not in the pocket, Bridget. I'm afraid being in danger of going out of business. I know I said that in an earlier scene, but I won't repeat it just in case part of the audience didn't hear.
So, you're still planning on burning it down for insurance fraud?
I don't see any other way. Besides, we can roast some marshmallows over the plane, so it's a bonus.
There's still no flight. I don't see any snow out there right now. And yes, I will continue this conversation in front of other people so that they're aware of my situation. Keep crying, Alfred!
Who's Alfred?
Oh, he's just my butler. I mean, my buddy. My buddy, yes. I always call my buddies outstanding in a crisis.
Well, speaking of crisis, I'm having a bit of problem with furnace. Maybe you take a look at it?
Furnace, but why would I?
Because you're a handyman?
Oh, yes, yes, I'm a handyman, and my specialty is
feet.
So, furnace sounds right up my alley, so to speak.
Great, so if you could fix the furnace, I could bake some cookies, trade?
Goods for services, yes, of course, right.
I'll show you the way.
Fantastic, I'm excited to get to work on the feet.
I'm excited to watch you work.
I'm excited for your cookies.
They are tasty.
I bet they are. Hopefully not too fat.
Okay.
Reality, it wants to open up. There's so much hidden there, trapped, waiting for the right touch to let it all out. It's very, very passionate about
you. That's what I figure too, yeah. And now it's for the romantic Christmas themed activities to help our heroes ignite that passion.
Yes! In a competition to see who can be the cutest!
That's right. Cheer for the couple that's your favorite.
So keep track of your favorite couple and be ready to cheer for them at the end.
Yes. The couple with the least amount of votes will be devoured by wolves in Act 2.
Seriously?
Yeah, we spent most of our budget on wolves, but skipped out a little trainer, so...
All right, then.
Couples, come on out!
Thank you.
downtown Hopewood Falls. It's a delight to
work. I don't know we've got slaves at the downtown, but we can't. Here. It's
allowing me to see things in a new light.
Is it?
And I see your light. Holly, I have to tell you something. I haven't been completely truthful with you.
Excuse me? You're interrupting our extremely cute snowball fight that we were having over here?
Actually, we were here first. You so forgot to mention that. And it was about to be a life-changing moment because he was just about to come out of his coma, but you ruined that. So Merry Christmas, I guess. Although that so wasn't in the Christmas spirit what you just did.
Look, you can keep having your snowball fight if you want to keep doing that.
You can't have two snowball fights at the same time. That is ridiculous.
Look, you're not even having a snowball fight. You're having a snowball assault. That's a snowball assault. It's not more violent than I remember.
Yeah, that's right.
So, what is it you wanted to tell me?
I...
Fine. Then we'll just go ice skating because that's a couple of times I've been
here in Hopewood Falls, we have plenty of time for Christmas-themed activities. It's a slower life here. Sometimes it hurts.
I'm afraid I'll fall.
Everyone is. That's why you need someone strong who can catch you. Who won't fall when you land on them. Who can pick you up again afterwards and let you skate some more.
I always thought I could catch it. That's why I became a pirate. What am I talking about? I can't let myself get swept up into this. What am I doing? We're important yet. That's my career in the big city. I can't steer. This is totally not a symbolic representation of my life. You called me.
I did.
You were there for me when no one else was.
Yes.
Actually, we are ice skating right now, so we have to ice skating. That would be great. I haven't actually seen skating. Well, we were preparing to skate, so. Come on, sweetie.
I don't care about the presents. Underneath the
balls, sweet balls, so hot.
Thank you.
the hell are you?
Texting me. Look, this one says,
Errol, I want to thank you for showing me what true love is.
Oh, that is so sweet, right? And this one is just row after row of kiss emojis. Sometimes guys have a hard time expressing their emotions.
So,
it's meant to be. This was such a good talk. You're my favorite sassy best friend with red hair. Sure. Nothing can go wrong now. It's time for things to go wrong.
The complication.
Now, in Act 2, we are switching things up. Instead of aww when I ring the bell, you guess. Like this. Let's try it.
I am not who you think I am. I'm actually a smurf! This is not my real face! I'm actually your grandpa!
Alright, here we go. The complications.
Glistened as he tore his flimsy shirt from his chest.
as she gazed upon his gleaming, smooth pectoral muscles, wriggling fills of man flesh.
I made some improvements on you.
Glad I can help. I have to go back to New York early.
What?
Some complications came up with my book.
The day before Christmas?
Don't ask it to make sense, babe. I have to go.
Wait! No, Paul! You're just putting up all these walls around you! I know, because that's what I used to do before I met you. Well, I'm not gonna let that happen. I'm gonna put a diamond around those walls and I'm gonna knock them down!
Walls are steel reinforced for just such a purpose.
Well, I bought a diamond bit laser to cut through those walls.
My walls are reflective, so your laser bounces off.
I will climb over.
They're super high.
I'm a really good climber.
There are spikes on top. I'm sorry, I can't do this. I have to go.
Paul, don't you want the romance of your life to be as good as the romance of the books?
Looks like I've been spotted. Whoops!
have ideas about what it means to be an independent woman that are at odds with the small town values here in Oakwood Falls. So I'm doing an elaborate dance where I pull away and give you money, even though I secretly want to stay, which I will only realize after I hear mocking me out a window and look at snowball.
I'm sorry, you cannot lose the truth about me.
Okay, that was weird. But luckily, I'm too self-absorbed to ask many questions.
I have a check for a lot of money, but I don't want it because I can't cash it with my heart. No one heard that? Seriously?
Fine.
I missed you guys so much while I was in a coma. I know. Thank goodness you escaped that crazy lady. I'm just so glad that even though I'm a widower and my wife died on Christmas, I have so much love in my life. With love to you guys, who needs human interaction? You guys are the best.
Justin!
Oh, crap. How did you find me?
Duh, I had your dog's chip when you were in a coma. That way I can find them always. Oh, wait.
Who are you?
I'm Carol. Don't you remember? Here, I found your ball.
Carol, I have no memory of you.
That accident must have erased your memory. Luckily, you can check your text messages to me.
Carol, before I met you, my life was a barren expanse of lifeless pain and cheap floozies. Now I'm alive again, and it's all because of you. You're my life, my light, my everything. You are all I think about and all I dream about. Yes, I'll pick up milk from the store.
That was in response to my text stuff.
Wow.
And then look at all of these photos of me in them that totally aren't photoshopped at all.
I guess I do love you.
Oh, it's a Christmas miracle! Alright, silly, time to kiss. Whimper, whimper.
Oh no, I don't think Francis is feeling well.
Let's take him to the veterinarian!
I'm a veterinarian.
Maybe you should check him out.
Right.
Whichever. Whimper, whimper. Well, he's lived a full life.
He's two.
In dog years, that's a lot.
Just help me get her in the car. I'll put her in my lab.
I know. Let's take a sleigh ride to your clinic. So much more romantic that way.
Car.
Okay, car. Fine. I just like a little magic in my dog rescues.
Can I talk to you guys for a second?
Hold on, we're getting ready for the walking in the snow montage.
Set the sad Christmas music.
Right, but I just don't think my storyline is setting a good example for people. Like, I was unconscious.
Right.
And then she stalked me, and then robbed me, and then now she's gaslighting me.
Sounds like most relationships.
Amazing that it all works out.
No, it's not. My character's been assaulted and brainwashed.
With no.
Okay, listen. I were a woman who fell unconscious, and then a dude came up and stalked her.
It would be Sleeping Beauty.
I'm pretty sure she's coming in like a dozen crimes so far.
Committing crimes in pursuit of love isn't actually a crime.
Yes, it is. There are laws.
Not on Christmas, there aren't. We have to suck it up and play your part. We're replacing you with one of the dogs.
Fine.
Now it's time for the sad part of the show. Sad part. And Vegas.
All right, everybody, off!
When I was a kid, I remember opening up presents on Christmas Day. That was a special time for me!
Thank you.
that my love poisoned my dove so we could share a special moment. She seems fine.
It takes a lot of love to poison a dog.
No, it doesn't.
Could I just tap on him? Kind of anything. Close anyway.
I love what you've done with the place. I mean, my place.
I'm not selling the inn there to you.
You don't have a choice. I'm buying this inn, and I'm going to bulldoze it tomorrow on Christmas Day.
Are you working on Christmas?
It's especially evil this way. I'm guessing that you won't be needing this mistletoe anymore.
Monster!
Think of it this way. When you're single forever, you'll have plenty of time to drink organic smoothies with all the other lonely single women.
Well, friends, it's time for
the grand gesture!
Things look bleak for our heroes. No one is going to be with their love!
Christmas is doomed, y'all! There might not even be a Christmas this year!
You're alone! No one loves you!
The cat is puking our hairballs!
But there's one thing that can save it all!
The grand gesture!
Which always involves somebody running!
Ah!
that you are!
That's literally what I said I was!
You went in.
I said I was a location scout. But I'm not a location scout. I'm actually an extremely famous actress. Look. See?
I'm so sorry. Do you know her? It's not ringing a bell.
Rita St. John. I am one of the 20 or 30 biggest up-and-coming stars according to the June edition of Entertainment Weekly. I hid my true identity from you because I didn't want you to fall for me just because I'm rich and famous.
You made it famous?
Yes, a lot, almost, basically. And I love you, Sven, even though you're poor. I forgot what you said your job was.
Pheasant.
Right.
But I have something I must tell you. I am not actually pheasant. I am actually Prince of Roxyback, and I have a lot of money.
But yes! Sweet! Boo! Take that, losers! I scored a prince! Oh, Merry Christmas to me! You have crown jewels, right?
Yes.
I get the crown jewels, right?
Thank you.
going out for several hours.
Hours! Some of the greatest hours of my life. Some ice skating in a small town really changes the way you think about things, doesn't it? What did you come back for?
Isn't it obvious? I've come back for you.
What am I here for? I mean, I'm here, but you hurt my heart. Feel it.
Yeah.
It's hurting.
Hold on. Let me feel it once more. If you could flex a bit, I'd feel more.
It's too late, Mary.
I need to tell you something.
What?
Just ignore that.
You'll always be pulled towards your phone. And your job as a real estate lawyer business person in a big city? I'm just not the kind of guy for you.
This is Mary. I don't think we should buy the farm.
What?
You heard me. Some things are more important than golf courses. Like small towns and Christmas. And Christmas trees. And Christmas tree farms. I didn't understand that before I came to Hopewood Falls, but now I do. I'm quitting my job as a lawyer real estate business person in the big city. And I'm moving here. So you can go build your golf course somewhere else. The people here can't afford it because they're too poor and old-fashioned.
Did you mean that?
Well, I kind of said dramatically, so I guess, but I'm all in, Blake. I don't need a job, or a career, or income, or a place to live, or food, or clothes. When I've got Christmas,
and I don't need this check! God!
Four down, two to go!
Back at the inn!
Maybe it would be so bad to have smoothies all the time. I think the hotel.
Only some kind of miracle we're about to happen.
Oh, no, I have internal injuries.
Dude, you're supposed to fall.
I can't fall.
I got this.
Hi-ya!
Now I really do have internal injuries.
I don't care, you're engaged to somebody else. What?
But I don't love her. She's rude and disgusting and I hate her. She's real thin and wears way too much makeup. She's kind of harsh.
Really a stereotype of a human being. The kind of girl standing a hero at the beginning of a film who's a complete—
Get the point!
I haven't been completely honest with you. I'm not actually a handyman. I'm a prince.
Yes! I don't care.
I also bought the inn from the developers.
He's a rat! Woohoo!
And I want you to be my princess. Mushing-like tower, plunging everyone into eternal night. And then everyone will be forced to swear allegiance to you and pay you for sunlight. You are going to rule with an iron fist.
Very creative. I'm gonna keep it the same. Yeah.
Or that.
I'm a big fan of keeping things just the same. Just like the Hallmark Channel.
Me too. Me too.
I scored a prince, yo!
L-O-S-E-R-S.
Losers!
I'm being a prince.
Me too.
Artemisia.
What he said.
national bird of Roxtonburg?
Yes, the flies ate the birds, so only the flies are left. But it gives the peasants something to distract from their crushing poverty and infectious diseases. And German mines.
Mines?
Yeah, there are streams of pee coming from the goats that gnaw on children. It's the main natural resource.
The correct stuff!
Aren't you able to turn around all the human rights abuses they've been doing to get the sanctions lifted? Good luck!
Hey, honey! Weapons?
No.
Are you really using some weapons?
This is
lovely.
Hey, do you want to like switch princes? That'd be cool. Sven is like totally into you.
No, I'm good.
Oh! Almost there. One left.
What?
want you anymore. I want this random American woman that I met this week. When I renounce my crown, I will live here in poverty with this lady. Be gone.
No! I am evil and I hate you!
And now it is time for the happy ending!
You really don't want to buy a heart in this small town.
Because you've got each
other.
Oh, look!
Mistletoe! Wow.
So, are you gonna kiss me or what?
I thought you'd never ask.